In previous topic, we have seen how to build images and how we can optimize image size while using the layers. Now, there is another challenge that we have, right? For metadata service, we had to build the artifact outside and then build the image, right? However, if let's say I have a use case where I want to use the Docker to build my artifacts, so running a Maven package command inside my container, let's see how that looks like, right? So in my same application of metadata service, what I've done is I have created another file called dockerfile.build. In this, instead of taking the base image as OpenJDK Alpine, I'm taking the base image as Maven. Let's look at the base image Maven. So Docker images, I've just pulled all different variations of Maven. To find out what are the options available, I go to the Docker Hub, search for Maven, go to the Maven official images, and I see that there is a documentation. In this documentation, they provide all the details about variants as well. The Alpine is just 122 MB. The default one is 508 MB and the slim one is 420 MB. We can use any one of these depending upon use case, you choose the right one. So in this case, just to differentiate from normal Alpine, I'm just using direct Maven. Working directory is set. I'm just copying my pom.xml file, which is where my all dependencies are specified, and downloading all the Maven dependencies, and I'm copying my source file. This is how we optimize our Docker images, right? So if there is no change in my pom.xml, my dependency fetch is going to reuse the layer. Then I change this, I run my Maven package command, and then I run my metadata service from the target folder. That's the difference in this file, right? Let's run this and build the image, right? So let's see what images I have, Docker images. So I have my metadata first one with fat jar copying inside the Docker container. This is one where I split my jar into lib and application code. Now let's do the next one. So I say Docker build minus T. I'm giving this name as metadata build. I'm specifying my Docker file as I have a different file name, which is dockerfile.build. This is my file name that I'm specifying. Context is same dot. This is going to take longer because it will download all my packages from internet dependencies in Maven. Started this. You notice that this step has started, the step number 4 that you notice here, and now it is going on. It'll take longer. What I'll do is like I'll fast forward to the step where it gets over. So if you notice, it took very long. My dependency command took almost 14 minutes, and that is because of my internet connection as well. Then I copied the source file, I ran the Maven package command, it ran, and that also took around some 30 seconds. Then at the end, entry point, right? So it took around 15 to 20 seconds, 20 minutes, right? Now if I say Docker images, you'll notice that I have my metadata build image, which I built, which is 637 MB. Let's see what's there in it, right? Docker history, metadata build. Now, if you notice, starts from here, where I have my image. Then I create my working directory. It's fine. I copy my source file, pom.xml. Then I get all my dependencies downloaded. That's 102 MB. So it took time to download this 100 MB, all dependencies. Then I copied my source code. Then I copied, then I run the Maven package where it built the metadata service.jar. So now I have this image, which is there. So I run image metadata build. See, metadata build. I'm running the image. Started. I can see the logs also. You'll notice that the application has started on port 8080. Right? Now I can the application and look at it, right? Now if I would like to go inside my meta build container, I'm inside this. I have all my files here. I can see, I can go to the target folder and see that I have my metadata service.jar also created. And I have given the entry point so I can run the application itself, right? However, again, the problem is that I have this big image, right? Which is 637. The previous one was just 127 MB. Now, actually, what I want is that I want to build an image using Maven as my base image. However, when I want to run my application, I don't want that overall, whatever the .m2 folder that I downloaded and everything that I did to build my image, right? I can just use the output of the artifacts that I want to run the image. And that's what exactly is the problem that we have to solve, right? For that, we have multi-stage builds. One more thing that I want to demo is, now if I run this same old build command again with build 2, you'll notice that it works very fast because it uses all the cache layers. There is no source code change there, right? Now if I go and change the source code, so I'm changing only one bit in my application property, just metadata service hello. I'm just adding some word here so that I get change. If I go and run the build as 3, you'll notice that my pom.xml and everything was fine, but after I copy my source, it ran all the instructions again and rebuild the image layers. As you notice, it did not download the packages from internet because I've separated that step instructions into my Docker file. Now I have images. Build 2, build 3, I have many images, all are same size. So let's look at what are the multi-stage build. In multi-stage build, you can have as many stages as you want, but right now in this example, I'm using 2 stages. The first stage is the build stage, and the second stage is run stage. In the build stage, I want to use the base image as Maven. In the run stage, I want to use the base image as OpenJDK Alpine. Now in the build stage, I want to do all that I just did, where I copied my pom.xml, given my MVN dependency to go offline, and then copy my source code and build a package. Now I have named my build stage as build so that I can use in my run stage here, where I specify that I want to copy file from my build stage, which is inside my target folder here, into my current metadata service.jar. Multi-stage build file looks like this, where build stage is same, my run stage is where it's like the old file, where only the difference is the from build here, right? And I'm good to go. So that's the multi-stage Docker file. Now let's run this multi-stage Docker file and see it in action. Now I want to create the multi-stage Docker file, right? To do that, I'll just create new file, docker.multistage. So I'm writing my new Docker file, docker.multistage. Steps are same. On the last step, I am exploding the image in the build stage. Now, when I do the run stage, I'm copying it one by one in an optimized way so that my layers of the lib and classes are different, right? This is another way to optimize. So I'm taking multi-stage with all the optimization that I can do for my Spring Boot application. Going ahead, Docker build, say build final, and Docker file dot Docker dot multistage. Now, if you notice, it just worked like a charm, right? Even though my file is different, it used the cached images from my previous build that I have done, right? My pom.xml is same. It picked up from cache, dependency picked up from cache, source picked up from cache, and everything is built. However, from this onwards, where I extract my target metadata service.jar, the fat jar, into separate parts, it created the images. Now, if I go and look at my images, if I look at my final one, which is again 127 MB, with all the build and everything happening inside my container. So if I go ahead and make a change in my application property, hello world. Okay. So my source code is changed, not the dependency. If I build final two, you'll notice all the previous layers are leveraged up to my source code copy because there was a change in the source code. In parallel, if you notice, there is a container running here, which is the temporary container that Docker build command creates. In long running builds, you can see this. In quick builds, you can't see that. Okay, gone. So I have my new Docker image, Docker images. I have my two also built, which is again 127 MB, which is fine, right? I just changed my code. I am able to run my multi-stage build happily with all the builds happening inside my container. Exercise time, again, you have to create the multi-stage build and a multi-stage Docker file for your metadata service. I have already showcased the whole demo with the metadata service only. So you can do the same thing. Stage one build, stage two run, and build the image. That's your exercise number four.